here on the left, I just spotted something. Yes, ultimate brutalist architecture. Right, I think we might have our first bit of greenery in the area. Let's go see. There's the gym. It is a very nice running track. Look at that. Wouldn't mind a go on there. People are busy working out. Yeah. Maybe we can stop and have a quick look.
This is really smart.
So, what we've got here is our only real park in the area in Maida Vale. I guess as you get a bit more central, greenery gets a bit more precious. It's not as commonplace as maybe in some of the other places we visited in the Ealing and Acton episodes, perhaps. This is known as the Paddington Recreation Ground. 27 acres, but quite a lot of it is taken up with the likes of this in front of me, which is football pitches, athletics track, five-a-side pitches, sports areas. There is a bit of a park bit somewhere. I can remember once sitting in it and enjoying a bit of summer. So we're gonna have a look around like we've been doing at the other places and see what this park's all about. Now, I've just remembered an interesting fact about this area. One of the other notable residents who has a blue plaque here somewhere is a certain Mr. Roger Bannister. But he was the first man famously ever to break the 4-minute mile. You know, that was quite a big deal, yeah? Breaking a 4-minute mile was something special. And apparently, he used to train at this sports ground, so maybe on this track. This was his training area, his training ground to do it. So, it's a pretty good fact for the area, I thought. Roger Bannister, 4-minute mile, here, Maida Vale? Come on, not bad. There's the world's cutest dog. Hard work, dogs in general, or these dogs?
I think like puppies.
Puppies, yeah.
And I haven't had like experience before.
Oh, come here. Come say hello.
Hello.
He's a poodle. Yes, a poodle. He is a poodle, isn't he? You have to show him who's boss, but he's too cute. Well, three shot. I'm kind of wondering how I'm going to get out now, though. I think I've trapped myself in between football pitches. Ah, there you go. What a nice little cafe. Everybody's sitting outside. Look at this. Here we go.
I can improve upon my facts from earlier. While a medical student at St. Mary's Hospital Medical School from 1951 to 1954, trained on the cinder track on this site in preparation for the first under 4-minute mile. Run in Oxford on the 6th of May, 1954. There you go. See? Facts. Blimey, there's a horse. Otherwise known as the Great Dane.
Got another blue plaque down here, so who's this? Oh, this is more my street.
Sir Bradley Wiggins, CBE. Enjoyed the facilities at Paddington Recreation Ground and lived close to the site, attending nearby St. Augustine's CE High School. Sir Bradley became the first British cyclist to win the Tour de France and is the only cyclist to have won the Tour de France medal and an Olympic gold medal in the same year.
Nice one, Bradley. Touch of class. Oh, this place is great. More outdoor gyms. Yeah, let's get up there. Right, let's do the cruise around the park. Pick up the pace a little bit carefully. Right, look at these tennis courts on artificial grass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Great facilities here. Great. Even more tennis courts. Shut your neck. Another 8 courts here. Cricket pitches. All right. I used to play cricket, loved it when I was younger. Good catcher. And a really good eye throwing the ball. If I say so myself.
Well, that's the first. I've seen a mini bandstand before. Look how small it is.
It really is mini.
Well, this is the perfect opportunity just to take 5 minutes to recharge myself and recharge my batteries and everything. And before we move on to the next part of Maida Vale, see what else we can find. Do a bit more exploring, get ourselves a bit lost, see if we can find some estates and alleys maybe, who knows.
So it's time to reveal why we're here in this lovely salubrious area that's nothing like the rest of scuzzy London we've been exploring so far. The reason is, obviously, I lived here. Why did I live here? How did that happen? Well, let's get into that story a little bit. So whenever I'd been looking for places to move to in the past, it was kind of on my terms, you know? I was ready to move, or I needed to find somewhere, or whatever it was. But this time, I had to move and find somewhere, well, kind of on somebody else's terms, because they were moving out, and I had to go as well. So there was a time limit on it. And I didn't realize, but that made it a little bit tricky. Suddenly, there's a deadline and I have to be out by. So I saw quite a few of these other places and, you know, they were so-so, or didn't quite work out. And in the end, I was running out of options. So I had to kind of speed things up a little bit. So when I came to see this place, I pretty much had to take it because, yeah, I was out of time. I didn't mind it. So I thought, yeah, let's go for it. Give it a try. It might only be 6 months, might be a year, who knows, not long. But I need somewhere, and that place is right here. This is it, one of the red brick mansion blocks. Now, my room was in a three-bed flat. Up there, you can see that white balcony. That was it. I had, like, prime position. It was that balcony and the three windows you see along the top there, and there's windows at the back as well. And it was a huge flat. And one of the reasons I took it, apart from having the top balcony in the best spot, I had a big double room, there was a living room, two other bedrooms, but the big plus point about it was, the guy that was living there was hardly ever there. He was hardly ever there. He came and used it once a week, once a fortnight, something like that, hardly ever. So basically, I had this three-bedroom flat in the middle of Maida Vale with a balcony terrace overlooking this area, just around the corner from BBC Maida Vale Studios. I basically couldn't say no. So it was a pretty top spot. Now the thing was, I didn't meet the guy, I met his wife initially. She showed me the place. When I met the guy afterwards, his wife, he turned out to be a great bloke, and we actually became friends for a while. We'd go out and have some drinks and have a laugh. He was ex-military, I think quite special in the military, maybe. But he's a great bloke, so we had some good fun together, which was a real bonus. So I kind of liked it there. Yeah, and from here, my commute to work was, I used to carry my bike up those four flights of stairs or something every day. Had a mountain bike then. And I would ride down that direction to get on the Regent's Canal, or Grand Union Canal, actually. And then cycle myself out to work, which is about 4 or 5 miles or something, 6, 7, 8 kilometers, something like that, along the canal, which was a nice ride, actually. After that ride, my workplace moved, which meant that I used to have to then get a train out to it because it was so far out of town. I would ride to King's Cross train station, put my bike on a train, and head out of town. But that prompted another move, which will come in the next episode. That's the story of Maida Vale and why we ended up here today. We're just coming into Maida Vale now, where the tube station is and the two shops nearby, and a good pub on the corner. I remember having a few drinks in there. Again, got these nice brown windows. Yeah, very nice. Well, once again, my curiosity is leading me somewhere because I see a cobbled street. Oh, okay, it's over. So I'm gonna, I don't know, go down here. We've got an estate, typical housing estate. This is called the Mortimer Estate. Goes through. What else we got? Big. Turn right, try that. Okay, let's turn right. Check out the dead end. Maybe I can get through here. Yep. Go on, take me out somewhere. Come on, there's a road, there must be a way out. Well, I just made that up, it's not true. Steps, damn it. Looks like we're crossing the track somehow. Kilburn is a slightly lower grade version of Maida Vale, I suppose. Still in a decent area, but
Not quite as flash. Just heading back over the tracks, just want to have a quick look in here because this looks quite interesting. Yes. This is quite well known. I don't know what it is, but I've seen it many times and you might have too. But this is a bit classic. Ultimate brutalist architecture. So I knew this was in the area somewhere, but I didn't know where it was. We're going to stop and have a look for sure. Look at this. This is absolutely incredible.
This is amazing. It's a little bit like those Dutch housing experiments. Definitely has that feel of a housing experiment about it when some clever architect thought he was clever and thought, I know, let's build everything out of concrete. Well, it kind of worked, obviously, but I think he didn't account for the fact that it starts to look old after a while. I didn't know I was so into architecture, but I do find it amazing. When you live in somewhere like London, and you've got such variety of it all next to each other, it is pretty incredible. Maybe we'll go there on one of these trips, like the Barbican, which is a bit more, not touristy exactly, but a bit more well-known in central London. Ooh, what happens if I go up here? Oh, God. Of course I have to have a look, don't I? Absolutely epic. That was another alley. This is too tempting. I have to do all of this stuff. Look at that. How cool is this? So happy. This is so cool. What a find. Kilburn. Result. Oh, wow. Urban Explorer's playground on a bike. This is the best. Oh, come on. Where else can I go? Let's go see what we got on this side. Directly opposite. Well, that was cool. I do like riding towards the States. I feel like an urban playground. Just here on my left was once one of London's richest streets. Loads and loads of basement dugouts going on here, that sort of thing. Probably one just right here. But yeah, these houses are pretty mega. So a lot of standalone massive houses here. We're gonna cross to the other side. I keep comparing things like this to Bishop's Avenue, but if you don't know what Bishop's Avenue is, then you won't know what I'm comparing it to. The long wide street, part of St. John's Wood, NW8. No, still in Westminster, that makes sense. That's where the money is. Right, this is the really expensive side of the street. Hamilton Terrace. Check them out. Absolute monsters, there you go. Basements, that's what I was saying. All these houses are big enough, so big, and yet they're also having basements done as well. Massive basements. All detached. That, I can see four floors, no doubt there's a basement, and maybe another basement, fifth floor. Oh, nice off-roader. Okay, so scuzzy London has changed for a, for a few minutes. I only like it because I'm amazed by it, that people in this world have so much money, and so many people have so much money. It does kind of amaze me where it all comes from, you know? And are the rest of us all doing something wrong? We must be, you know, got what we've got and that's it. These people, it's just normal to them. This is their normal. Living in 25,
30, 40, 50 million pound houses. So this street's actually a lot longer than I thought. That's what you get. Now, we need to get back on track, which means I need to spin it around again and go the other way. So let's do some of that. I'm not going to show you the rest of it. You've seen it now. Sit down, we've seen ya. Right, let's just boot it along Hamilton Terrace. To our left, beyond the houses, we have Maida Vale proper. This side from here on up, we have St. John's Wood. This road might be quite well known actually. Abbey Road, does that mean anything? Abbey Road. Yep, Abbey Road, as in Abbey Road. It must be a nightmare when you're driving along here, because every time you try and come along here, you've got people trying to cross the zebra crossing for some strange reason. And why would that be? There they all go. Sorry peeps, but you know, it's the name of the game. Let's have a look at this. Where's everybody written all over this wall? Because that right there is Abbey Road Studios. And this wall famously gets written on by everyone. That's not me, although I am here. The building you see behind me was once a 9-bedroom Georgian townhouse built in 1831. However, it didn't stay that way for the rest of its life. It was in fact bought by the Gramophone Record Company in 1931 to be used as a recording studio. Of course, famously, four lads from Liverpool turned up in the 1960s to do some recording here. They turned out to be the world's biggest ever recording artist, most famous. Of course, I'm talking about the Beatles. Just there, we have a very famous bit of street furniture, which has always got visitors on it. And in 1976, it was renamed from EMI Studios to the now world-famous Abbey Road Studios that everybody knows it as. In 2010, it gained Grade 2 listed status. Of course, they can't stop people writing on the walls outside. That's always going to happen. I think that's gone on for decades, and it's probably always going to carry on. One of those few things that people tend to turn a blind eye to in, you know, in the eyes of the law. I'll just give you a quick look at what the area is like around here. So you've got red brick mansion block here again. Normal street with lots of flats and big buildings. And you've got this one individual Georgian townhouse. More flats on a busy road. And to me, it's a bit like the Maida Vale Studios. It's a little bit strange that, you know, a place to put a music studio in the middle of all this residential stuff. It seems a little odd, you know. Music is loud. When you play it properly, it can be loud. So why they end up in these residential areas, I don't know. And like I said, there's always people crossing at the zebra crossing just here, trying to recreate a famous album cover. So let's just go and have a look at some of these people having fun doing this. That's a good one. It must be a nightmare if you drive and you live on this street and you're trying to get home every night. Maybe I could do something a little different. First person to roll across it on a bike. Right, let's get the hell out of here. That was Abbey Road Studios, obviously. I said we weren't going to do any tourist spots on this trip, but there was always going to be a few of them creep in here and there, you know. You can't avoid it when you come through areas like this. So we just about reached the end of the whole Maida Vale story now. What did you think? Interesting place? Somewhere you want to live? Maybe you want to visit? That's probably a bit more like somewhere you might want to visit, this area. There may be other reasons for that. For example, right here, this is Lord's Tavern. So what does Lord's Tavern mean? Well, it means you've got Lord's Cricket Ground right here. Let's see if we can get a bit of a sneaky look at it. There's some cricket fans, and there's the ground. It sounds like there's something going on. We might actually cruise round to the far side of it and try and take a look from the north side, I think it is. But yeah, we're not going to go in detail in there. Loads of cricket ground. You all know about it. It's a big deal. But I'm not going in. But you can, there's some of the stands, look. And the floodlights. The home of cricket. Amazing. And there's some nice, lovely, beautiful, brand new flats opposite. What a place to live.
Oi, oi. Well, that was weird. I just bumped into my neck, literally my next door neighbour.
Absolutely crazy. I saw this guy across the road staring at me and I thought, what's he looking at? I thought, I know him. He's my neighbour.
How strange.
All right, let's get up the road here and have a quick look at it from the other side.
Well, this is kind of a bit of a bonus.
Wasn't planning on doing this, but we're so close to Lourdes, we might as well have a quick look. Actually, see the ground. Look at that, I didn't expect that.
Wow.
The North Gate.
Just a quick little bit of bonus footage there for you cricket fans out there.
We're just cruising down this street now, just to have a last little look. St. John's Wood before we leave. Anyway, that's it for today.
There you go, St. John's Wood High Street. It's a very nice place. So we're going to coast down here, down to the end, to Prince Albert Road. Hang a left, and start heading out of town. Until the next one, we'll see you somewhere
on Scotty London.
The day I die.